report.
Our search for answers into the elusive coconut tree prophets in Kenya took us to Majikuko village in Kwale County. 55-year-old Mwinyamiri Bendera has been in this coconut business for years. But it was only until recently that he began to realize profits.
Hapo mwanzoni nilikuwa nikivuna napata kama nazimia kuanzia 500 mpaka 600-700 hivi. Lakini hivi sasa nimeongezeka labda kama mara mbili hivyo.
Just like many at the coast, he had neglected his trees. It is estimated that more than half the coconut trees in the region are as old as 70 years and above, with most farmers only relying on knowledge passed on to them by their forefathers, which explains the low productivity over the years.
We still have the old, what we call the African total, tall tree. That one has been overtaken by time. That one takes seven years to 7.5 to flower, probably 8 to 10 years to fruit.
But even those can be worked on to produce well. Now Mwinyamiri boasts of having over 200 such coconut trees. But largely, his success currently has been catapulted by the Micro Enterprises Support Program Trust, MESPT, a program funded through the Royal Danish Embassy.
We are also supporting them with exposures, and not only the producers. In 2012 is when Kenya, for the first time, made a very notable presence at the Asia and Pacific Coconut Community exhibition and conference, which was held in Kochi in India.
Mwinyamiri is also a nursery operator, developing seedlings for free distribution to farmers. The government says there is a need to plant more trees and is chipping in through the Nuts and Oil Crops Directorate.
2013-2014, we were able to distribute over 460,000 seedlings.
There is a ready market for the coconut raw material. For example, the Serendi Kenya factory, located just a few kilometers from Mwinyamiri's farm, has contracted over 800 farmers to supply them with quality coconuts.
We are organic certified, so the market demands only nuts which are coming from certified farmers.
The company collects between 15,000 to 20,000 nuts daily and then presses them to produce virgin coconut oil. To further emphasize the different uses of the coconut and its byproducts such as the husks, nothing brought to the company goes to waste. They are used to heat the machines.
We are focusing on green growth for sustainable development.
Elsewhere in Mazeras, Kilifi County, entrepreneurs have discovered they can produce more than oil from the nut. Established over 2 years ago, the Kentest Products Company has gone yonder and now produces coconut milk and cream, products which are now in major supermarket shelves in the country.
Actually, we were assisted by MESH, made for us some labels for the start. The ideas were there, but the funds were not there.
Other establishments such as the Career and Sons Company in Mtwapa have taken on a different path. They use the coconut waste to produce fiber, and this is used for making mats and ropes. Needless to say, the three factories are willing to expand, but cannot do so now due to lack of enough coconuts to keep them running throughout the year.
You see, we can no longer ignore the coconut tree. It has so many benefits that Kenyans have to simply tap into its unexploited potential. Peter Mongangi, NTV, Kwale County.